In this video, we'll be going over what to expect during and immediately after a kidney transplant surgery at Children's Hospital Colorado. A kidney transplant is a very complicated surgery which tends to involve several tubes, drains, and overall monitoring. Before the surgery begins, your child will be given general anesthesia, so they will not feel any pain during the procedure. While your child is asleep, the anesthesia team may place a central line or arterial line before the kidney transplant starts. These lines help monitor blood pressure and overall fluid status. A Foley catheter will also be placed before the operation begins. This catheter helps monitor the urine being made by the new kidney and also helps to protect the sutures attaching the ureter to the bladder. The soonest the Foley catheter will be removed post-transplant is 3 days. At the end of the kidney transplant, the surgical team may choose to place a JP drain near the kidney to monitor for bleeding or urine leaking. JP drains are closed suction devices which collect bodily fluids from surgical sites. After the kidney transplant is done, your child will be taken to the pediatric intensive care unit, or PICU. Here, the nurses will send frequent labs and monitor your child. The surgeons will remain in constant communication with the PICU team. An ultrasound will be done of the new kidney when your child arrives in the PICU. The urine output will also be monitored every hour. Your child will receive a lot of intravenous fluid in the first 24 hours to keep the new kidney happy. This means your child may look puffy, which is normal. There are occasions where your child may need to be on a ventilator after the transplant or may need hemodialysis. These are both temporary measures and will be stopped as soon as possible. Your child will be allowed to drink after the surgery and will usually be given food the next day. For more information about kidney transplants, please watch our video, Pediatric Kidney Transplant, Overview and Procedure.